Hello everyone, this is my video on boats and streams, and let's get started with our video. And we've already finished a video on boats and streams 1, and this video is talking more about the problems on boats and streams. Firstly, we have a question here which talks about a man takes twice as long as to row a distance against the stream as to row the same distance in favor of the stream. The ratio of the speed of the boat in still water and the stream is. So it very clearly indicates here a person takes twice as long as to row a distance in boat against the stream as to row the same distance in favor of the stream. Very clearly indicating upstream, while traveling upstream, the boat takes twice the time when compared to it traveling downstream. So which means this time taken ratio is 2:1. As we all know, if the time taken is in the ratio 2:1, the speed would be in the ratio 1:2. So if the upstream speed is going to be 1, and downstream speed is going to be 2, and we obviously know a still water speed, the boat speed in still water will be in between these both, so it's going to be 1.5. so if that is the case, we obviously know the stream speed should be 0.5 here. So 0.5 gets added to 1.5 gives you 2, and 0.5 gets subtracted to 1.5 gives you 1. 2 gives you a downstream speed, 1 gives you upstream speed. So we know the stream speed here is 0.5, and speed of the boat in still water is 1.5. So what is the ratio between speed of the boat in still water and the stream? So it is nothing but 1.5:0.5, very clearly indicating the ratio is nothing but 3:1. A very simple concept. So we're going to solve more questions on this so that we could master this technique. So let's get into the next question. Our next question says, a boat running upstream takes 8 hours and 48 minutes to cover a certain distance, while it takes four hours to cover the same distance running downstream. What is the ratio between the speed of the boat and speed of the water current respectively? This question is a very similar question to the previous question, but the only difference here is they've given you the time, which says a boat running upstream takes 8 hours and 48 minutes, while downstream it takes 4 hours. So when we take the time taken ratio, the time taken here, so upstream here, time taken would be upstream, it takes 8 hours and 48 minutes. 8 hours gives you 8 into 60, 480, and we have 48 minutes added to it, we get 528 minutes to go upstream. And for downstream, it takes 4 hours. 4 hours is nothing but 4 into 60, it's 240. So 240 minutes. So we get 528 minutes is to 240 minutes. So when we try to reduce this, we would get a ratio divided by 12. I think 12, when you divide it by 12, I get 20. When we do the same here, we would get the ratio as 44. So the ratio of the time is 44:20, nothing but 11:5. So the time taken is in the ratio 11:5. Then speed would be in the ratio 5:11, which means if we assume the upstream speed as 5 and the downstream speed as 11, and we obviously know the speed of the boat in still water would be between these both, that would be giving you 8, because 5 plus 11 is 16 and the divided by 2 gives you 8. So still water, speed of the boat in still water will be 8. Then the stream speed should be 8 plus 3 gives you 11. So stream speed here would be 3 subtracted from 8. So stream speed is 3. So which is going to be telling us the speed of the boat in still water will be 8:2, stream speed is 3. So ratio is going to be 8:3, a very simple scenario. So again, a very simple question with the same concepts as the previous question. So it is just taking 20 seconds for us to solve these questions. Let's get started with the next question. So a boat covers a certain distance downstream in 4 hours, but takes 6 hours to return upstream to the starting point. If the speed of the stream be 3 kilometers per hour, find the speed of the boat in still water. This question is a bit different from the previous question, but it almost works the same way with a small difference in it. That is, 4 hours is the time taken for it to go up downstream and 6 hours for it to go upstream. Again, we could get the ratio out of it and we'll have to start substituting the values. So if that is the case, we know time taken here is downstream it takes 4 hours, for upstream it takes 6 hours. So very easily telling you the time taken ratio is 2:3. If time taken is in the ratio 2:3, we know the speed will be in the ratio 3:2. So if this is the case, we know downstream speed is 3, if we assume the downstream speed as 3 and upstream speed as 2, we obviously know the boat speed in still water will be 2.5, which very clearly suggests us the speed of the stream should be 0.5, But as per question, we know the speed of the stream is 3 kilometers per hour. So if that is the case, we know if the speed of the stream is 0.5, our speed of the boat in still water, speed of the boat in still water is 2.5. If it is 0.5, the speed of the boat is 2.5. But as per question, it's 3. If it is 3, what will be the answer? Either cross multiply or else 0.5 into 6 gives you 3. So 2.5 into 6 should give us the speed of the boat in still water. So if it's 0.5 into 3, 6 is 3, then 2.5 into 6 gives us 15 kilometers per hour. That will be the speed of the boat in still water. Again, a very simple concept. Yep. So we'll get started with the next question. The speed of the boat in still water is 6 kilometers per hour. If it can travel 72 kilometers downstream and 24 kilometers upstream in the same time, the speed of the stream is. By telling 72 kilometers downstream and 24 kilometers upstream in the same time, they're trying to tell us the time is constant here. So when the time is constant, which it can obviously give us the speed, the ratio of this, the speeds between both of them, or the ratio between both of the speeds. So if that is the case, probably we'll understand it even better. If a person is trying to travel at 10 kilometers per hour and another person travels at 20 kilometers per hour, and both are traveling for 5 hours each, and we know initially the ratio is 1:2 here, the speeds ratio is 1:2. If they're working for, they're traveling for 5 hours, we know 10 into 5, he travels 50 kilometers, and this person, when he travels 5 hours, he will travel 100 kilometers. The ratio is still 1:2. And if they travel 10 hours, it will still be 10 into 10, 100 for this person, and for this person, it will be 20 into 10, it's 200. So it still stays at 1:2. So when the time is constant here, we could very easily understand that the speed remains the same. The speed remains the distance covered or by them is going to be staying in the same ratio, and the speed ratio is also going to be staying constant. So if that is the case, with that, we are going to solve this problem with this concept. So it is given that a person travels 72 kilometers downstream and 24 kilometers upstream in the same time. So which means 72:24 is going to be the speed ratio. So which is nothing but 3:1. So if speed is in the ratio 3:1, we know the time taken will be in the ratio 1:3. So time taken will be in the ratio 1:3. So if that is the case, the question very clearly says the speed of the boat in still water is 6 kilometers per hour. So we know this, if this is going to be the, this is going to be downstream and this is going to be upstream. So we know speed downstream is 3 and upstream is 1. So if that is the case, then our downstream speed is 3, upstream speed is 1, and boat speed in still water will be 2. But as per question, it should be 6. So when we multiply 2 with 3, we'll get it as 6. So if that is the case, they're asking you, what is the speed of the stream? Speed of the stream, for that we could still find the upstream speed will be 3 then, and downstream speed will be into 3 gives us 9. So downstream is 9, boat speed in still water is 6, and upstream is 3. So obviously the stream speed should be 3, because that 3 gets added to 6 and gives you 9, that gives you the downstream speed, and 3 gets subtracted here and gives you 3, which is your upstream speed. So this is as simple as that. Again, a very simple question. So let's get on to the next question. A man can row 50 kilometers per hour in still water and the river is running at 10 kilometers per hour. If the man takes 1 hour to row to a place and back, how far is the place? So this is again a question which is talking about time and the speed concept. With the same concept, we're going to solve this question. A man can row 50 kilometers per hour in still water and the river is running at 10 kilometers per hour. So it's very obvious. If the speed, a person's speed in still water is going to be 50 and 10 kilometers per hour is the stream speed. So if 10 kilometers per hour is the stream speed, then upstream speed will be 40 and downstream speed will be 60. So if that is the case, speeds ratio is downstream is to upstream is 60 is to 40 is nothing but 60 is to 40 is nothing but 3 is to 2. So speed is in the ratio 3 is to 2. We know the time would be in the ratio 2 is to 3. Time would be in the ratio 2 is to 3, which means for him to go from A to B, it takes 2 parts of the time, and from B to A, it takes him 3 parts of the time. So if a person has to travel from here to AR, so he has to from A to B, for him, this person when he's going, is going at 60. When he returns, he comes back at 40. And it takes 2 parts of the time for him to go from A to B, and 3 parts of the time for him to travel from B to A. And something which is very common here is, the person traveling from A to B, whatever distance is covered, will be the same distance for him to travel from B to A. So if we are able to find the time for any one of the speeds, or the distance for any of the speeds, that will give us the distance very easily. So which means the speed is in the ratio 3 is to 2, then time taken would be in the ratio 2 is to 3. So the total time taken in parts is going to be 2 is to 3 is nothing but 2 plus 3 is 5 parts. He takes 5 parts of the time for him to reach, go and come back. And as per the question, they say for him to go and come back, it takes 60 minutes. So 60 minutes is nothing but 1 hour. So it takes 1 hour for him. So this 5 parts is going to be 1 hour for him. So 5 parts is 60 minutes. Then as per question here, this person, for him to travel downstream, it takes 2 parts of the time. So 2 parts should be giving us the answer as 24 minutes. Cross multiply, or we could still say it as 5 into 12 gives you 60, and 2 into 12 gives us 24 minutes. So if 24 minutes, if he travels at downstream speed, we know it's going to be 60. So he travels 60 kilometers per hour, and if he travels at 60 kilometers per hour for 60 minutes, if he travels at 60 kilometers per hour for 60 minutes, then for 24 minutes, how much does he travel? So the distance is going to be 24 kilometers. So that is going to be the answer for this question. So let's get started with the next question. A man rows 4 kilometers per hour in still water. If the river is running at 2 kilometers per hour, it takes 90 minutes to row to a place and back. How far is the place? So very obvious here, a man can row 4 kilometers per hour in still water. If the river is running at 2 kilometers per hour, it takes 90 minutes to row to a place and back. So this question is very similar to the previous question. So it is very clearly given here, still water, the boat speed in still water is going to be 4, and 2 is going to be the stream speed. If 2 is the stream speed, we know upstream speed is going to be 2, and downstream speed is going to be 6. So if that is the case, we know downstream is to upstream. Speed will be in the ratio 6 is to 2, it's nothing but 3 is to 1. So ratio of the speed is 3 is to 1. Then time taken will be in the ratio 1 is to 3. As per question, we know that it's totally taking 90 minutes. Here, as per parts, we know it's going to be 1 plus 3, it's nothing but 4 parts. So 4 parts is equal to 90 minutes. So as I said, for him to travel from A to B, and he has to come from B to A. So the distance remains same. So we could very easily say for him to travel at 6 kilometers per hour at one part of the time will be the same as he traveling at 2 kilometers per hour for 3 parts of the time. So with that concept, if 4 parts is 90, we know one part is going to be 90 by 4, nothing but 22.5 minutes. He travels at 22.5 minutes, he can recover the distance. And very clearly this question says he travels at 7 kilometers per hour. So 7 kilometers per hour is nothing but 7 kilometers for 1 hour, which is nothing but 60 minutes. He travels 6 kilometers for 60 minutes, He travels 6 kilometers for 60 minutes. For him to travel 22.5 minutes, how much distance can he cover? We know for 60 divided by 10 gives you 6, and 22.5 divided by 10 should give us the answer as 2.25 kilometers. So the distance covered by him is going to be 2.25 kilometers. So this is again a very simple concept. So boats and streams found to be one of the toughest topic by many students who are preparing for placements, and also for people who are doing their GRE and other higher levels of exams, but who are preparing for higher levels of exams. But I would very easily say the concept through which you solve makes a topic tough or easy. For me, the technique that we use is very important. I believe these techniques can help you to solve this topic better, and you can be a better person in solving many tough questions with your right techniques. So I would like to thank you so much for the time and patience that you've been having to watch this video. I'll see you on my next video. Kindly like, subscribe, and comment on my video. Thank you so much for your time and patience.